Clay Daniel, director of LSAT prep for Claiborne Education. Talking about the LSAT, I want to get fairly granular here for a moment. In the LR section, there's a number of questions that have to do with assumptions, but it would be a mistake to think that they're all of the same kind. There are two fundamental kinds of assumptions that have some important differences even in the midst of their similarities. There are necessary assumption questions and sufficient assumption questions. The difference between these two can be often very confusing to students, I've found. So let's take a word picture as an example. Think of a necessary assumption like a leg of a stool. If I were to ask you, okay, here's a soundly made stool. It's functional. If you sit on it, it will hold your weight. And it has three legs. Those legs are placed appropriately spaced out so that the stool works. What if we were to pull off one of those legs and sit on the stool? Disaster and pain, right? What we've discovered there, of course, is that that leg that we just pulled off the stool was a necessary part of the stool. Now, conversely, let's say that we have the same stool. Whether it's sound or not, we put it on top of this massive tree trunk. The tree trunk is directly holding up the actual seat of the stool. There are no structural problems in the tree trunk. It's massive. It's way bigger than what is actually even needed to hold up the stool. Let's say you sit on that. Is that tree trunk sufficient to hold up the weight, your weight? Absolutely. Now, here's the difference, though. Think about it a little bit more. Going back to the leg of the stool, is it necessary to hold up your weight when you try to sit on the stool? Yes. But once the tree trunk is in place, you don't need the legs anymore. The tree trunk is sufficient to hold up the weight of the stool. Is the tree trunk sufficient? Yes, absolutely. Is it necessary to hold up the stool? No, because when's the last time you saw a stool held up by a tree trunk, right? There are other ways to build the stool. Is that leg of the stool necessary to hold it up? Yes. Is it sufficient to hold it up? No, all three legs are needed in a normal stool to hold it together. All right, now let's try to take the word picture to the actual LSAT question. A necessary assumption is an unstated premise, something latent in the argument that the author is counting on being true, such that if it's not true, it's like pulling a leg off the stool and then trying to sit on it, which is why the negation test can work so powerfully with necessary assumptions. That is, if you think you've found the right answer, test it by saying, well, what if the opposite of this was true? What if I negate the main verb? Or negate the substance, the heart of the sentence? That should be like pulling a leg off the stool, and the argument should fall apart, fall to the ground, just as you would if you tried to sit on that stool. Now, sufficient assumption questions are going to feel a little bit different. You might come to an answer that feels like, well, wait a minute, that's not latent in the argument at all. It's not necessary for the argument to work, but that's not the question sufficient assumptions are asking you. They want to know, if this is true, does the argument work? And you're going to find, as you get used to sufficient assumption questions, that that argument is going to feel airtight, no more doubts if the right answer is true. All right, last thing I want to say to help you think about the differences. The differences have very practical outcomes in many ways, including the language of the choices. Necessary assumptions tend to use what we would call more modest language, more qualified, less extreme. Sufficient assumptions tend to have more what we would call bolder language, less qualified, more extreme, more absolute. And that makes sense, right? Because if we're trying to identify something that's latent in the argument, we don't want to overstate that. We don't want to say that 10 legs are required to hold up the stool. That's an overstatement and therefore not necessary. 10 legs aren't necessary for most stools. 3 will do just fine. So we want a more modest answer typically on the necessary assumption side. But on the sufficient assumption side, we want to feel like there's no more doubt that that stool will ever have a problem. It's going to stay up no matter what. The bigger the tree trunk holding it up, the better. So it's hard to overstate the strength of the answer you need on sufficient assumption. A word like always or only or never is a great word for an answer to a sufficient assumption question. All of this takes practice, but if you begin with an understanding of the differences between the two kinds of assumption questions and what you're looking for in the answers, you can apply those principles for consistent success. This is the kind of thing we talk about all the time in our one-to-one LSAT sessions. I'd love to talk to you more about it. Come talk to me about the LSAT, how to prepare for law school, and how to crack the code of this test.